Hey everybody, Coach Eric Broza here at the Dragon's Lair, and of course this is full-time bodybuilding, and I am here with one of my best clients. We've been together for 2 years now, going on year three. His name is Tim Martin, and Tim is actually competing this weekend. What's the name of the show?
The Sin City Showdown.
Sin City Showdown, which will be Saturday. Tim is actually, you're 60 now?
Yeah.
Are you 60?
61.
He's 61 now, so he's a master's competitor. And he's doing men's physique, and I have him here today. We're going to do a little chest and shoulder workout. But what we're going to do is we're going to actually take sort of like the highlights of the chest workout and the highlights of the shoulder workout and show that to you guys. So this way you get the best of both worlds. Again, I can't absolutely kill Tim because he's only 2 days from a show, but we'll still put him through the ringer a little bit. So I hope you guys enjoy the show, and thank you for watching as always. Okay guys, so we're starting out this chest workout today with the guillotine press, which is one of my favorite movements to hit the clavicular or the upper chest muscle. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna lay on the bench press here, and instead of bringing the bar down to the nipple level where you normally would, we're gonna go all the way to the upper chest. So the elbows are gonna be back again, a good stretch on the upper chest. We're gonna use 4 second negatives. So it's gonna take me 4 seconds to lower the weight on each rep, and then I'm gonna explode to the top looking for somewhere around 8 reps or so. Okay guys, so what we're gonna do for the second exercise is we're gonna do this seated chest press here. And the technique that I wanna use on this one is pause stretches. So what we're gonna do is when we come back to the stretch position, I'm gonna have Tim on film for this one, he's gonna hold that deep stretch on the muscle for a full 4 seconds. Every time you stretch a muscle under tension, that signals the body to grow. In other words, it tears apart the muscle tissue, sets the anabolic machinery into motion, and it's a very, very important growth technique. So watch how we do it, and then give it a shot at home.
All right.
Whenever you're ready.
Get the first one going.
So watch as he comes, he's gonna hold that stretch. 4, 3, 2, 1, then a boom to the top. Hold. 2, good. Stretching all those fibers from the armpit into the sternum. Stretch under tension, tremendous growth technique. Now, I didn't want to kill Tim today, but Tim wants to kill himself, so we're gonna do it. Hold your stretch. Squeeze with the chest, go. 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Good, still in the game. 4, 3, 2, 1, press. Good, finish out that one. Good, okay. Okay, so we finished our chest workout. You saw the highlights of the chest routine. Now we're going on to shoulders. And I'm gonna start out with a superset to fill these shoulders with blood immediately. Today we're only doing the anterior, the front, and the lateral delts, side delts. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a superset. We're gonna do an incline front plate raise. Very, very strict. We're gonna try to raise the dumbbell to about eye level. And then we're gonna go from there right into a heavy side lateral, a partial rep side lateral. We're only gonna be using about the first half of the rep and keeping the tension on the lateral delts. This is an amazing superset for bringing about a pump and, of course, muscle growth. Thank you. top. I'm really trying to squeeze. Doing it on incline, it's a much stricter way to do it. And leaning forward like this is a better contraction at the top. Partial side laterals. Keeping the tension on the lateral delt the whole time. And I'm focusing on pushing the dumbbells away from my body. Awesome. Okay guys, we're gonna have some real fun now on this side lateral machine. Very, very intense technique, which involves holding the contracted position for the first 10 reps and then changing speeds and going to a quick 10 reps afterwards. So what we're gonna do on the first 10 reps is we're gonna hold that top contracted position, really, really squeeze and focus on the lateral delts for 4 seconds at the top. After we complete 10 good reps like that, we're gonna drop the weight by just a little bit. And then we're gonna do 10 quick, still under control reps. So we're changing speeds, we're using the contracted position technique. This will really torch the lateral delts. If you have trouble building width in the delts, give this little drop set a shot. All right, here we go. Hold. So as you can see, he's holding that contracted position for 4 seconds before lowering under control. And he's mentally focusing on squeezing the lateral delt. He's not just holding it in place, he's doing what I like to call hypercontracting, which is focusing on squeezing as much as he can at the top. This creates a tremendous amount of tension in the muscle and the muscle fibers and really allows him to isolate those lateral delts. Obviously, when you try this technique, you can't go as heavy as you normally could. Way more difficult, so cut the weight down by a good 20 to 25%. When he hits that 10th rep, he's gonna drop the weight. Here he goes. And I'd like to remind you, Tim is 61 years old, and he's crushing it harder than most 20-year-olds. Come on, here we go. Come on. Up, 7, up, 8, up, 9, one more, up, 10. Good. All right, guys, so we just finished our chest and front and side shoulder workout. And I'm gonna talk to Tim for a little bit here. But the first thing I wanna ask him was, how was that workout?
It was great.
We used some great techniques. And the funny thing is, I said right at the beginning of the video, I don't want Tim to train too hard because he's got a show in 2 days, but there really was no holding him back. Like once we started, he was already getting extra reps and I was like, okay, I guess he just wants to go, so we're just gonna go. So I'll have to give him some extra carbs tomorrow, maybe, to help him make up for it. But one of the things that Tim and I were talking about throughout this workout, so we've been training together for about 2 years now. One of the things that I taught him right from the beginning was the difference, the tremendous difference that having a mind-muscle connection while training makes in terms of how you feel the movements, you know, how hard it hits the muscle fibers, what a difference it makes in terms of keeping injuries away because you don't have to go as heavy when you're more connected to the muscle. And of course, overall progress because, you know, there's definitely a lot of people out there who think that, you know, once you turn, you know, 40, 45 years old, you know, you can't make any more gains, you know, like that time has passed. Well, Tim's just hit 61. He's way bigger and more developed than he was 2 years ago. So that myth is completely destroyed. So Tim, how much has that mind-muscle connection made a difference in your training?
It's made all the difference in the world in my training. You know, it actually makes it fun when you can connect that mind and muscle. connection. It just, you don't have to use as much weight, and it's just better pumps, everything. It just, and better results, obviously. The thing without going heavy, not that ego lifting like everybody wants to do. It's just truly is amazing the way it works.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely worked as, you know, so well for you. Definitely allows you to have more longevity in the sport, you know, because you can keep improving without having to, you know, damage your joints or every night coming home and being like, can't move your lower back, your shoulders, your knees. You know, those things tend to happen after years of lifting, but you know, you don't really feel those things because, you know, you're, but the thing is that when you're lifting the weight, when you have that type of connection, plus also using these different techniques that we use, like slow negatives, holding the stretch position, slow positives, holding the contracted position, you literally can't use as much weight. You know, you're forced to use less weight, but the weight feels as heavier or heavier than when if you were just moving the weight up and down, correct?
Yes, exactly, yes. Yes, and then when you want to, you know, you feel like it, you can go grab heavier dumbbells than what you're normal doing and you can rep them out, you know what I mean? I don't ever use the over, like a 70 pound dumbbell with your type of training, but yet I can grab the 90s and rep those out for 10 or 12 also, but I never touch those anymore. There's no need to for me, you know what I mean? So I don't do that ego lifting, and my joints never hurt or nothing doing that, being able to control the weight instead of, you see other people in the gym and they're just throwing, using every ounce of their body or something, trying to move the weight instead of just using that muscle that they're actually working. If they're working the chest, you can see them, they're using everything, leg, push, everything besides their chest, really, so.
Well, so we're doing the Sin City on Saturday. I think that you're obviously in the best shape of your career so far,
without a doubt.
Actually, I haven't, you know, we do this long distance, so, you know, everything's done through email. So, of course, Tim sends me pictures every single week, as all my clients do who are getting ready for shows. And I could see the changes that were happening through the photos. But when I saw him today, which has been the first time in a while, I walked into the gym and he greeted me, and I was like, wow, I couldn't believe the difference between the photos and what you look like in person. So we're going to do this show. Hopefully we'll have a great result. Of course, like I tell all my clients, I tell Tim, I tell everybody, the main goal is to beat your former self. If you have done that, then you have won. Again, you cannot control what the judges think of you. You can't control who shows up. The only thing you control is yourself. So if you've beaten your former self, then you've won. And then we're going to go later in the year to the Masters USA and go after a pro card. You know, that should be fun. And we should probably, whatever condition you're in now, we're going to again try to beat it.
Yep.
But this guy's going to take a little vacation, I hear. Where are you going?
Turkey.
Turkey.
Yep.
He's going to Turkey. Probably won't just eat turkey.
Yep.
go on a boat for a while. Like you said, you're going to go on a boat.
Yep.
So that should be fun. And then when he gets back, we're going to go right back to work and pursue the next goal. So anyway, guys, thank you for coming on this journey with us. I hope you guys enjoyed the workout. I hope that you guys will get something out of this. Remember to like and subscribe to the channel. And if you have any comments or questions that you want to make about the workout, if you want to ask me more about what we did, what the sets and reps were, please just put your comments in there and either Dave or I will get to it. So thank you for watching. We'll see you next time on Full Time Bodybuilding.